Home runs aren't the only way to score runs in baseball, but they're the only way to single-handedly ensure your team puts a run on the board. So let's talk about the players across Nippon Professional Baseball League history that did that better than anyone in our top 10 power hitters of all time ranking. Now, power hitting isn't only limited to hitting homers, but for the purposes of this video, the main benchmarks we'll be looking at are career home runs, at-bats per home run titles, slugging percentage, and isolated power. There is really two kinds of players that find themselves at the top of the all-time home run leaderboard. We'll call them accumulators and peakers. Accumulators may not ever reach extreme single-season heights, but consistently hit 30 homers a year for maybe their entire career. And peakers may not play or be as good for an extended period, but are truly pushing the limits of power with multiple 40-plus or even 50-plus bomb campaigns. We're going to try to balance these two career types to ensure everyone gets representation, but this list is just so stacked that some cuts will obviously have to be made. And keep in mind, we're only talking about a hitter's pure power here, so their all-around game like contact hitting or defense does not matter. Getting us started at number 10, outfielder Koji Yamamoto. Yamamoto played for 18 seasons with the Hiroshima Carp from 1969 to 1986, smashing 536 home runs during that time with a 542 slugging percentage. His peak years were from 1977 to 1981, when he recorded 5 consecutive 40-plus homer seasons with 44, 44, 42, 44, and 43 jacks respectively, with over 100 RBIs and an OPS over 1,000 in each of those seasons. That is some incredible consistency. Yamamoto is 4th all-time in homers, won 4 home run titles, 2 MVP awards, and homered every 15.02 at-bats throughout his career. At number 9, outfielder Vladimir Valentin. As far as peaks go, this guy has everyone beat, as he set the single-season MPB record for homers back in 2013 with a monstrous 60-bomb campaign. To be fair, the balls were juiced that year, and he was the first foreigner to not receive the Sadaharu Oh treatment of being intentionally walked as he approached the record, but still, 60 home runs is just insane, and he slugged 779 with 449 isolated power. Also, the next closest player in homers that year, Tony Blanco, finished 19 behind Valentin, so let's just admit that he was an absolute monster. Valentin never reached those heights again, but he's still technically an active player with 301 career homers at a rate of 12.48 at-bats per homer. Valentin is definitely more of a peak guy than a longevity guy, but he was the most feared hitter in Japan for most of the 2010s and won 3 home run crowns and an MVP award with a career slugging percentage of 546 and 280 ISO. I have an entire video on his journey to stardom, so please check that out if you're interested. Next up at number 8, designated hitter Hiromitsu Kadota. Kadota is 3rd all-time with 567 career bombs at a rate of 15.64 at-bats per homer. He didn't have his first 40-homer campaign until his age 32 season in 1980, but then he did it 4 more times, topping out at 44 jacks in both 1981 and 1988. He won 3 home run titles, an MVP award, and slugged 529 for his career with 240 isolated power. He played for 23 seasons and averaged about 25 dingers a year, so he's a bit more of an accumulator, but he definitely had some pretty huge years sprinkled in there. Coming in at number 7, first baseman Alex Cabrera. Steroid allegations aside, nobody hit bombs quite like Cabrera. His raw power was truly unmatched, and he ended up hitting 357 homers from 2001 to 2012. But the first 3 seasons were by far the most impressive, as he crushed 154 bombs with 49, 55, and 50. For his career, he homered every 12.63 ABs, won a home run crown, an MVP, and slugged 592 with an ISO of 289. He also has the official record for longest home run in MPB history at 180 meters or 590 feet, which may not be fully accurate, but that really shows you just how strong this guy really is. And he even broke the single season home run record in his native Venezuela after his career in Japan. At number 6, first baseman Randy Bass. Now, as far as peak performance, Bass is pretty much only matched by the legend Sadaharu Oh. And the only reason he isn't any higher on this list is that he only spent 5 full seasons in Japan for circumstances beyond his control, aka the Hanshin Tigers, releasing him for having the audacity to return to the United States after his son was diagnosed with brain cancer. But during his short tenure in Japan, Bass was truly incredible with 202 home runs across only 614 games, or a home run every 10.93 at-bats. He won two home run titles and an MVP award, as well as winning back-to-back triple crowns in 1985 and 86. He maxed out at 54 jacks in a season and slugged an astonishing 660 for his career with 323 isolated power. That's just nuts. He also became a US congressman after he retired, which is pretty interesting. From batting power to political power, am I right? Next at number 5, outfielder Tuffy Rhodes. Rhodes basically accomplished what all the other foreigners did, only he did it for 13 seasons. Now, his peak was not quite on par with Bass or Cabrera or Ballantyne, but he averaged over 35 homers a year, including a stretch from 2001 to 2004 where he hit 197 homers, including two 50-plus bomb campaigns. With 464 dingers, Rhodes is the all-time home run leader among foreign players, and he won four crowns and an MVP award in the process. He homered every 13.52 at-bats, and he slugged 559 with 273 isolated power for his career. At the number 4 spot, infielder Hiromitsu Ochiai. Despite not playing his first full season until age 27, Ochiai still finished with 510 homers for his career, good for 6th all-time. Ochiai won 5 home run titles along with 2 MVP awards and an all-time best 3 triple crown seasons. His peak can really stack up against anyone as he blasted a career-high 52 homers in 1985 with a .763 slugging percentage and followed that up with 50 more homers and a .746 slug in 1986. And unlike most of the other guys on the list, he barely struck out, though that doesn't really matter for the purposes of our rankings. For his career, he homered every 14.95 at-bats and slugged .564 with .253 ISO. Getting into our top 3 now, and it's outfielder Hideki Matsui. Of course, Matsui ended up going to Major League Baseball, so we never got to see how many homers he could have reached in Japan, but he ended up hitting 332 homers in MPB and 507 across MPB and MLB. Had he remained with the Yomiuri Giants, he probably would have approached the 600 mark. But Godzilla's achievements in his 10 seasons in Japan alone are enough to earn him this position. He hit 332 home runs at a rate of 13.77 at-bats and won 3 crowns and 3 MVPs. From 1996 to 2002, he averaged almost 40 homers a season, including a 50-bomb campaign with a .692 slugging percentage in his final year in Japan. For his MPB career, Matsui slugged .582 with a .278 ISO before going to MLB and slugging a very respectable .462. Matsui was truly one of the most dangerous hitters of all time, and he maintained that for a very long time. At number 2, catcher Katsuya Nomura. Nomura is a Japanese baseball legend for both his playing career and managerial career. He played for a whopping 26 seasons and hit 657 home runs, placing him second all time. But Nomura is not merely an accumulator. His peak was marvelous. From 1962 to 1965, Nomura hit 44, 52, 41, and 42 jacks respectively. The 52 bomb season is still the most from the catcher position in professional baseball history across the world. He won 9 home run titles, 5 MVP awards, and slugged .508 for his career with .231 isolated power at a pace of 15.93 at-bats per homer. Obviously, those rates are brought down a bit by the latter end of his career, but let's cut him some slack. He was a player manager for 8 seasons. Before getting to our number 1 spot, honorable mentions go out to Tokuji Nagaiki, Koichi Tabuchi, Katsuo Osugi, Ralph Bryant, Makoto Kozuru, Isao Harimoto, Takeya Nakamura, who's still an active player and quickly climbing up the all-time leaderboards, and especially Kazuhiro Kiyohara, who is 5th all-time with 525 homers, but never quite hit 40 in a season and never won a home run title. I also need to shout out Munetaka Murakami, who became the youngest player to reach the 100 homer milestone last year at just 21 years old. If he keeps that up, he'll find himself in the top 10 in no time. But anyway, at the number 1 position, it's obviously first baseman Sadaharu Oh. The Yomiuri Giants legend is the world record holder in home runs with 868. And please just do yourself a favor and take a look at his baseball reference page. It's disgusting. His name literally translates to king, and well, he was the home run king 15 times, including 13 straight seasons from 1962 to 1974. Nobody comes even close to that. He had 19 30-plus homer seasons, 13 40-plus homer seasons, and 3 50-plus homer seasons, including his original record-setting 55-bomb campaign in 1964. He homered every 10.65 at-bats for his career, which is just an incredible pace, and he slugged 634 with 333 isolated power. And he did this all in a pretty low-scoring era. He won 9 MVP awards and had 16 consecutive seasons with an OPS above 1,000, including 11 seasons with an OPS above 1,100, and 5 seasons with an OPS above 1,200. He also walked over 1,000 more times than he punched out for his career, and finished with almost 6,000 total bases. I could go on and on, but please check out my video on the greatest hitting season of all time for more on O. So there you have it, the top 10 greatest power hitters in MPB history. Unfortunately, some amazing players had to be cut from the list, but do you agree or disagree with my rankings? Comment down below. Special thanks to my patrons, Chris J, Jonathan Greenberg, Hino Sato Yaku, Poker Pack Rat, Corgi Racing, Anthony Pang, Jake Royce, Marcus Hill, Yuba Bird, Ryan Fox, Jeff W, Shar Aznable, Juan Jose Sanchez Bracamontes, Christopher Woods, Samantha Garavey, Yuki's Submarine, Kud, Jem Morelos, Gabriel Foss, and Kurt Berglund. Thanks for watching. Please like and subscribe for more MPB content in English.